Hello, my name is David. I'm a library assistant here at West Slope. I'm going to be talking today about our book group's reads for 2022. These are all the books that you all selected, and I'm going to be going through them one by one, month by month. So without further ado, let's get started. We're going to kick things off in January with The Death of Mrs. Westaway by Ruth Ware, who critics are calling the Agatha Christie of our time. This one is a great thriller. Starts out with a suspicious letter, then we get a mysterious funeral, some tarot card reading, and then we're diving down into the deep, dark family secrets. This is a must read for anyone who liked Women in Cabin 10 and In a Dark, Dark Wood, Ware's previous novels, as well as anyone who just enjoys a good thriller. In February, we have some investigative journalism with Patrick Radin Keefe's The Empire of Pain. This is a portrait of the Sackler family, well known for their philanthropy and patronage of the arts. However, they are also the family behind OxyContin, a highly addictive painkiller that is at the root of the opioid crisis. This work of reportage pulls back the curtain on generations of greed and secret deals that have led us to where we're at today. In March, we return to fiction with The Four Winds by Kristen Hannah, a lyrical portrait of a young woman in Dust Bowl, Texas, who must choose between risking everything on a move to California or staying where she's at to fight for her dried-up family's farmland. This one is an excellent character study and will be a huge hit with fans of historical fiction, but you've been warned. Make sure to bring a few tissues. In April, we have Yagyasi's novel Homegoing, which has been topping best-of lists ever since it came out. This is the story of two half-sisters in Ghana, one who rises to positions of wealth and power, while the other is sold into slavery and shipped to America. This is a beautiful work that spans generations and continents and shows us our own history in order to better reflect where we're at today. In May, we return to nonfiction with Unworthy Republic by Claudio Sanz, a history of the forced migration of some 80,000 Native Americans across the Mississippi in the 1830s, upending many of the myths we have come to believe about the inevitability of manifest destiny. Sant describes the political infighting, Wall Street manipulation, and the citizen resistance to what would become a government-sponsored tragedy of monumental proportions. June's pick is The Thursday Murder Club by Richard Osman. This is a witty and charming mystery about a group of friends in a retirement home who spend their Thursdays investigating unsolved cases. However, when a local property developer turns up dead, the group does not miss their chance, and the hunt for the killer is on. July brings us a memoir that has been stunning critics all year long. Beautiful Country by Chan Julie Wang is the story of the author's childhood growing up undocumented in New York City in the 1990s. Wang's book is an unsentimental portrait of life on the margins and is also an indictment on one hand of the American immigration system while being an affirmation on the other of the beautiful moments and the successes that her family shared. Next up, we have The Afghanistan Papers, Craig Whitlock's groundbreaking account of America's longest war. This investigative work dives into the secret meetings, memos, and phone calls behind three decades of hubris and mismanagement. This book really is a must-read and shows us that even though we all lived through the war, very few of us, presidents included, understood it. In September, we'll be reading Somebody I Used to Know by Wendy Mitchell. This book truly is a rarity, a memoir about Alzheimer's, written by a woman who is herself suffering from the disease. Mitchell is a former employee of the British National Health Service, and she writes candidly about her experiences with early onset Alzheimer's in this poignant and thoughtful book. In October, we have Matrix by Lauren Groff, who many of you will know from her novel, Fates and Furies, and her story collection, Florida. Matrix takes us back to the 12th century and charts the course of a 17-year-old former child crusader who has been kicked out of the royal court and banished to a failing abbey. This is a beautifully written tale that sets its characters against an immense historical backdrop of faith politics and power. Next up, in November, we have Uncomfortable Conversations with a Black Man by Emmanuel Acho, the host of a series of groundbreaking videos on race in America. Acho sets out to answer all the questions that white Americans have about race but are too afraid to ask. Tackling issues like white privilege and reverse racism, Acho dives into the fraught debate around race with an eye for compassion and understanding. And finally, we're going to be wrapping up 2022 with Pulitzer Prize finalist Leila Lalami's The Other Americans. This is the story of Nora, a jazz composer who returns home to the Mojave after her father has been killed in a suspicious hit-and-run accident. Blending religion and mystery into a compelling family saga, Lalami dives into race, class, and religion in this wild ride of a novel. Those are all of our books for 2022's Book Club. Thank you so much for watching. If you would like to join, all of the information is below me here on these links. Please click those to sign up. Shoot us an email, give us a call, drop in, ask us any questions you've got. We'd love to hear from you, and we are so excited to see all of you this year's book clubs.